It's the only thing that will limit reggae. And we have to pressure people in positions of power, and largely those are non-Jamaicans, and force them on a business level to recognize why they should include reggae, why they should educate their staffs about being able to promote and market a product if it's a record label. Here's what your staff needs to know.
Everybody will try to tempt you in this business, whether it's a reggae artist or a hip hop or anybody, you know, who's doing something that is from their heart. You'll be tempted to do things to cross over, to, you know, put out a record that you necessarily don't love because somebody feels it fits the marketing plan. Those are not usually the ones that work. If people can just kind of resist the last temptation, you know, I think we'll see lots of great music coming up to the surface.
I think the artist, the reggae artist that you need to look out for. It's all about Supercat. No, you think I'm joking. I'm not joking. He just signed to the Neptunes. I'm just saying that because I'm biased. But no, he, but you know, it's not that I'm biased, it's a fact. He's the best DJ of all time. Morgan Heritage. I really want to see this rock thing happen, and they're doing it. You know, they're recording with a lot of great bands. They're recording some really great stuff. And from the rock end, I think, you know, because they're already really great on the reggae side, I think it's really going to, it's gonna be like a breath of fresh air.
For DJs, you can look out for Assassin. You know, you can look out for Demo Delegado, Show Kiro. You know, you can look out for Vibe Cartel. You know, there's so many talented artists in Jamaica right now.
I would watch out for Vibes Cartel. Definitely watch out for Vibes Cartel. He's got a buzz. I'm hoping for a quartet called T.O.K. I'm hoping for another quartet called WAD 21, which is interesting that we have boy bands out of Jamaica that, you know, in the case of T.O.K., you have some real singers in this quartet. Not just acting like they can sing, real singers. And they can also switch and become what we call rappers. But they can DJ too. Stephen Marley, Julian Marley, Damian Marley. Ziggy's presenting his first solo album. Not to say that he's broken up. You can't break up with your brothers and sisters. He's still a melody maker, the leader of the Melody Makers.
The boy Elephant Man is already huge, so I mean, that's without saying. But you know, you got cats like Ellie, of course, Sean Paul, Wayne Wonder.
Wow, it's wide open for a lot of artists. I mean, when you look at someone like Sean Paul, who's relatively young in the pantheon of dancehall stars, and then you look at someone like Wayne Wonder, who is a big veteran. You know, Beanie Man can always bust out with a big tune. Bounty Killer is dealing with Swiss Beats right now. I think the potential is huge because there's always been just a bare sliver of the talent that's in Jamaica that's really exposed to a wide audience. And as new ears tune into this vibration, you could see a real explosion.
I don't care what they say, but you can say, girl. Keep on saying your thing, yeah. And I don't care what you do, but you can do, girl. Keep on doing your thing, yeah. And I don't care what you shake, but you can shake, girl. You have my head to spin, yeah. And I don't care what you kiss, but you can kiss, girl. You have this brother sing that. People keep on telling me that you're here to stay, yeah. But I keep on telling them that you will go away. Cause why? Two wrongs can't make no right now.
Dancehall music in 2003. It can go in a number of different directions right now. It's really an open season right now. I'm sure more labels will start signing reggae artists now. I mean, they will be fools not to. Obviously, the success of artists, you know, of the artists who had success in the past year or so shows that, you know, whether it's Shaggy or Sean Paul, that you can invest in a reggae artist, you can invest in dancehall artists, and reap the rewards of that if, you know, you're willing to take the time and you're willing to put together a good album.
If this music is looked at in its purest form and not, and people don't try to water it down, then this music will emerge and be a force to reckon with, because it has always been a force to reckon with.
I think it better be time for artists that make a lot of message tunes that have a sound like a Buju Banton, like a Bounty Killer. You know, I think that should be the next wave. But a lot of the onus for that success will be on those artists and the people that are around them to be able to step up and not only have the vision, but be able to take it there? Are you ready to rehearse? Are you ready to come into the studio? Are you going to be on time when you make a studio appointment? Are you going to know how to articulate what is important that people understand about you?
Breaking reggae into that rock scene now, I think, is the next thing that's going to happen for the music. Right now, there's a new punk rock movement that's going on that's, you know, really big here in America, that's number one on TRL and all that, with like the Good Charlottes and the Sum 41s. And these kids are very, if you ever ask them, the majority of them, their favorite music is reggae. I mean, you know, a lot of people in the industry realize that reggae is the glue between pop music and urban music. It's that one type of music that crosses all genres.
These artists are really getting, I feel like they're getting it to the sense of knowing the type of record to make, to make it to radio or to make it to that mainstream and stuff like that. So it's not going anywhere, man. We're just gonna take it to the next step.
The way that it would work is the way the Americans do it is like, if like Jay-Z's hot, Jay-Z put the next man on. One of his people, they put the next person on. They put the next person on. So by the time you get it, it's still a circle of the same thing. It needs to be more like unified. Cause it's hard, like when one man are blowing up, you know, the man just say, yeah, man, I'm me, I run things right now, you know, me, I run things, things to run, we all right, you know. And by the time he's done saying that, he's off the charts, you know what I'm saying?
Well, there is certainly, you know, from the dancehall standpoint, a large appeal to the urban audience. So I think there's going to be more and more, you know, in that vein. But, you know, you have other groups within reggae, like Capleton or a Buju Banton or a Morgan Heritage, that has a more of a roots appeal. And I think there could be a resurgence on that end also.
The future for dancehall is limitless. The skies.
This is Johnny Osborne, the dancehall godfather from Jamaica. Lots of things we see. I'm going to write that on paper. I'm an original Jamaica from Jamaica. And thinking of it like a computer. Like me in the dancehall, I'm see people enjoy themselves. I mean, also the soul man I play, dub play. You know, say, dub plates playing in the ghetto tonight. We're going to rock you tonight. Really going to rock you tonight. Hey, me operator, tell me, how do you feel? Play your little rub-a-dub style for me. Play your tin chapter like a 1, 2, 3. Come on, little children, this is ABC. Everybody dancing, girl, them keep on skanking. Really happy rocking tonight. Everybody talking, now the girl, them keep on skanking. Really happy rocking tonight. Dub plates playing in the ghetto tonight. And that's the dancehall. See, the real Makai.
Just give me the light. Just give me the light. Just give me the light.